Well, it's all right. Riding around in the breeze. Well, it's all right. If you live the life you please. Well, it's all right. Doing the best you can. Well, it's all right. As long as you lend a hand.
You can sit around and wait for the phone to ring.
Welcome, this is Michael Volkoff, and this is episode 246 of Corruption, Crime, and Compliance. In our episode today, we're going to talk about NAVEX Global's 2022 Hotline Benchmark Report, which came out just recently. And glad to be back, by the way, in the United States, back from Sicily. Hopefully, we'll keep up our podcast, and we have a new refreshed, rebranded podcast coming soon in a few weeks, so we'll keep you posted about that. But today what we're going to do is talk about the Hotline Benchmark Report. It's a shorthand for actually many more issues than that. But NAVEX each year puts out a benchmarking report, which is really valuable. And I commend everybody to take a look at it. I'll include a link in the show notes. NAVEX obviously is the leading hotline provider in the global market. So they have, and then what they do is they take all the data, make it anonymous, and then start to examine it and analyze it for trends on employee reporting, investigations, all of those types of issues. So, and each year they issue this report on, you know, whistleblowers, internal investigations, and potential retaliation. The database consists of 1,370,000 reports made in 2021 at organizations around the world. And in its report, NAVEX at first identifies two significant trends, which I think we've talked about before, but which are definitely continuing. On the one hand, companies are seeking to stabilize and sort of recover from the pandemic, and stabilizing now in the post-pandemic world and with remote reporting, remote working, and obviously 2021 was the year most known for the Great Resignation, resulting in an average of 4 million voluntary resignations per month. On the other hand, the issue that we're seeing is that whistleblowers and employees are emboldened and more comfortable in reporting concerns. One unfortunate finding from this is that we're also seeing an increase in retaliation rates, and that's been a steady trend that we've seen in the last few years, and retaliation rates are certainly something we have to be careful about and attend to in all of our programs, because it can have a devastating impact on employee engagement. NAVEX noted several significant findings, including declining levels of anonymous reporting, increasing reports, though, of harassment, discrimination, and retaliation that I mentioned, but harassment and discrimination claims up to the level of the height of the Me Too reporting problems. Not only up to, but NAVEX cited that reports of harassment exceeded levels from certain the time period of the Me Too movement, or the height of the Me Too movement. NAVEX also pointed to increases in incidents of workplace civility or incivility, largely stemming from public disputes relating to workplace safety. So aside from these sort of interesting trends that I just went through, let's go through in a little bit more depth five significant findings that I think, the five most significant findings. One, whistleblowers are becoming emboldened, and I mentioned that at the outset. 90% of all reports in 2021 alleged misconduct, as opposed to call-ins or contacts for guidance or questions. So the use of the hotline, the ethics hotline, is in nine out of 10 cases alleging misconduct, and that's an increase from 86% in 2020. And the corollary to that is that the volume of inquiries on policies and procedures or questions has fallen each year as a percentage of employee engagement and reporting. And it fell from 21% in 2012 to 14% in 2020 to just 10% in 2021. Fewer reports are now being submitted anonymously, and that's an interesting phenomenon. The number of anonymous reports fell to an all-time low in 2022 of 50%, and it went as high as 58% in 2020. The rate of decline in anonymous reporting is not just at a steady rate, but the rate is actually accelerating. And that, to me, is really an interesting phenomenon. In other words, people are becoming more comfortable or more willing to raise issues and attach their name to it and obviously then cooperate. And here's another really interesting finding, and it sort of buttresses a point that I often make. More employees are reporting concerns directly to managers or functional groups. So that, to me, I've always argued that employees want to report to their supervisors. Obviously, they want to report internally, but they turn to the hotline for situations they don't feel comfortable in. So while the overall median reporting rate remained the same from last year, that's for the number of reports overall, 1.3 reports per 100 employees. For companies that only track hotline and web reporting, as opposed to walk-in reports and other types of reporting, the median reporting weight was only 0.9 per 100 employees. However, for the companies collecting other reporting sources, that meaning walk-ins reporting to your supervisor, the rate was much higher, obviously, because you're capturing that data, but it's all the way up to 1.7 per 100 employees. And the difference between these two categories of reporting sources, that being just the hotline itself or emails, telephone calls, the difference has been increasing, NAVEX noted, and it reflects employees' comfort in reporting to supervisors and other in-person avenues. So that's a key finding. It's good to, and I've also advocated strongly for incident management, meaning you can't just capture hotline reporting, web reporting, and not include incident or walk-in reports as well in terms of people who come to HR, people who report it to their supervisors, one where they walk in and then they outline the concern. Another key finding, substantiation rates continue to edge upward. And the substantiation rate for employee reports edged upwards from 42% in 2020 to 2021, excuse me, to 43%. I'm sorry, from 42% in 2020 to 43% in 2021, and up from 36% a decade ago. The substantiation rates with regard to issues, specific issues, were the highest for data privacy concerns, 63%, environmental issues, 59%, and confidential and proprietary information, 54%. Interesting, the lowest substantiation rates related to alleged retaliation, where the substantiation rate was basically one quarter or 24% of the cases. Interesting that substantiation rates are going up, and maybe this is a product of better investigation follow-up. Reports about retaliation, harassment, and discrimination increased significantly, and I mentioned that earlier. In 2021, reports of retaliation nearly doubled from 0.9% in 2020 to 1.7% in 2021. Only 24% of these reports were substantiated. Like I said, reports of harassment, however, rose to 5.6%, an all-time high, and discrimination reports also increased to a record high of 4.7%. Reports of accounting, auditing, and financial reporting increased as well. Environmental health and safety issues reporting rates decreased. Financial reporting rates increased from 3 to 5% in 2020 and 2021, respectively. Now, that may seem low, but remember, when there's a financial reporting issue that comes in, that typically involves a greater amount in terms of investigative resources to follow up on these kinds of issues. So an increase from 3 to 5% is interesting as well and notable. The top five reported issues by, as noted by NAVEX, were health and safety reports, which were 11%, roughly, conflict of interest, 9%. I'm not surprised by that at all. Data privacy and protection, 5%. Discrimination, like we said, was up to around 5%, and misappropriation of assets, 4%. So this, again, we're seeing interesting data capture here of the types of issues that are being raised across all of these organizations in NAVEX Global's database. Let me address one final issue that NAVEX talked about, which was the continuing impact of COVID on reporting rates. The number of reports relating to COVID-19 issues rose and sort of fell at the same rate of overall levels of the pandemic nationally. As vaccine availability increased, the rate of reporting about COVID-19 issues fell. The median reporting volume, however, remains below pre-COVID-19 levels, but significantly, and this is kind of interesting, even though more employees are working remotely, employees are submitting reports at a faster pace. And a faster pace, I mean the time between the incident that occurs and the submission of the report. So again, COVID-19 still has there's an impact on reporting levels, their health and safety concerns, that even in the remote working context, we're still seeing these kinds of issues coming up. Well, that's a quick summary for the NAVEX Global Benchmark Report. I hope you can download a copy of it. It's worth a good read. I will put a link in the show notes, hopefully you get a chance to look at it. Thanks, everybody. We'll be back next week with another episode. Stay safe, stay healthy, and stay in touch. Thanks.
Thanks again for listening to Corruption, Crime, and Compliance. Please subscribe to the podcast series. The Volkov Law Group believes that every company should have a robust ethics and compliance program. Experience and research show that ethical companies are better performers in the global marketplace. You can learn more about the legal and compliance services we offer at our website, www.volkovlaw.com. You can also follow our award-winning blog, Corruption, Crime, and Compliance, and our podcast series. You can contact Michael Volkov at his email address, mvolkov@volkovlaw.com. Even if they say you're wrong, well, it's all right. Sometimes you gotta be strong. Well, it's all right. As long as you got somewhere to lay, well, it's all right. Every day is Judgment Day. Maybe somewhere down the road away. Yeah.
somewhere down the road when somebody plays
at the end of the line,
the purple haze.
Well, it's all right, even when push comes to shove. Well, it's all right, if you got someone to love. Well, it's all right, everything will work out fine. Well, it's all right, we're going to the end of the line.
Don't have to be ashamed of the car I drive. I'm just glad to be here, happy to feel that.
And
it don't matter if you're by my side, I'm satisfied.